center. Just make it a little closer. Now, this is the Mercedes three-pointed star that's been their symbol for a long while. I've actually got a number of different car key rings just like this that I'm going to show and talk about today. The first one that I've picked up is the Mercedes car company from Germany. Mercedes started in 1886. I'm not sure if they started with cars or some other type of machinery, but anyway, that's a pretty recognizable symbol. And three. Those are three points of the star represents land and sea and air. I'm not sure which point points to what, but I'm guessing the one that points upwards would be air, and the one that points down would be land, and the other one would be sea, or vice versa. So that's the first one for today, is the Mercedes-Benz, a German car. We have them in Australia, ever since I can remember. A luxury car is the Mercedes. Now, the next one is a Suzuki. It's the S4 Suzuki. Now, what actually happened was I was having a clean up, which I think I've spoken about a few times in some of my videos, and I actually found all these car key rings that I'd bought. Must have been maybe 4 or 5 years ago, with the thought of doing a video about them, but I put them to one side and forgotten about them. I bought them on eBay, and they came from, I'm pretty sure they came from China, and I bought them all individually. And stuff from China can take several months for it to arrive, but these ones arrive. There's a few more as well that I'll reveal as the video goes on. And I thought to myself, well, now would be a good time to do the video. So Suzuki is a Japanese car company. Started in Japan in 1909, and at the moment that's just a silver S for Suzuki, S-U-Z-U-K-I, but when you see the that S on their website, it's a big red S. It's a big, bold, and modern S for Suzuki, and there's got those sort of sharp edges on the S rather than around it. It's all, sharp, square edges there on the S, which represents, sorry, nature, which is very popular in Australia, and Ford's been around for many, many years in Australia, probably since the 1960s perhaps. It's the earliest one I can recall in Australia. That's the one that was made in Australia, USA, and Detroit is where Ford comes from. The blue silver oval logo, which they've used since 1965, although it's been modified over the years, but it's still that basic blue and silver oval is Ford, F-O-R-D, oops, Ford. Okay, that's Ford. I might put that down like there. Oh, that's a good idea. And line it up there with the Suzuki. Now the next one is the Renault, which has got the diamond. Now that diamond is supposed to be a optical illusion diamond. You can't really see it there, but it's one angle, and when you look at it down below, it's a different thing. So that top half looks in one sort of section, one sort of, I'm going to not explain that properly, but anyway, it's an optical illusion diamond. That look up there, you think something's happening, and you look down below and something's different happening with the diamond, which I suppose is a way of explaining it. Renault was a French car company. It began in 1899, and they had that diamond from 1925, and in 1973 it was redesigned as a 3D optical illusion diamond. So Renaults are in Australia. I see them. I see that big diamond on the front grille of their cars. I just couldn't think. Lost my train of thought then. What's interesting about the German brands, Mercedes and Opel, Fiat Italian, Renault for French, and Ford from the USA, is in their home country. They're all left-hand drives, but they make right-hand drive models. Oh, well, not Opel, of course, but with Renault, the Fiat, Ford and Mercedes, they make right-hand drive cars somewhere in the world to sell to countries like Australia, which is interesting. Now, obviously, Suzuki Japan is a right-hand drive country, so the cars are right-hand drive in their home country, and also in Australia. There used to be, not sure if they're still doing it, but they would sell second-hand Japanese cars used in Japan, and you could buy them in Australia. They'd put them on a boat and sell second-hand Japanese cars into Australia, which I always thought that was a bit strange. Was obviously a market for them. Maybe obviously they could sell them in Australia for more than what they could sell them in Japan. So it made it worthwhile putting them on a boat and sending them to Australia. Now the next one is the Walking Lion. It's the Peugeot French car company. is the walking line purchase started in 1810 in France, mainly selling saws, hand tools, coffee grinders, bikes, and around 1900 they branched out into cars, and it represents the walking line on the logo, represents power and sophistication. Peugeot's in Australia, I see that. That logo, the front grille of cars. But once again, I can't really remember the name of the brands, and that's probably not really the focus of this video. The focus of the video is to talk about these logos. So I was trying to work out what the winged arrow actually meant, but unless it's anything I could think of, is it sort of, you know, the cars, the arrows going very fast, and the cars are going fast, and they've got a wing on it. I'm not really sure. I tried to find that out, but I couldn't quite work that one out. Skoda. Yeah, Skoda's in Australia as well. They've got those Kodiak SUVs. There's one that I know of. But apart from that, there's a number of brands that they make. And so obviously they're from Czechoslovakia, which is a left-hand drive country, but they're making to sell in Australia. So, and other right-hand countries around the world, like England and New Zealand and India and all Southern Africa, are all right-hand drives. So, yes, what was I going to say now? So it's actually quite interesting. You know, I could put my keys on this Mercedes keyring and, you know, impress my friends when they sort of think I've suddenly got a Mercedes. But I've only just got a Thank you.